Now, so I start with a kind of formal survey of sheet on a topological space. All right, let X be a topological space, and consider the set O equals O of X, it depends on X, of all open subsets of X. The topology of X is defined in terms of the family of open subsets of X, which is a subset of the set of all set of X. I recall that the axiom of a topology is that O should be stable under arbitrary union and under finite intersections. All right? So O in particular is an ordered set by inclusion, and therefore O defines a category by abuse of language. We will denote this category by O also, as any ordered set does. If U and V are elements of O, namely open sets on X, the set of homomorphisms of U into V here will be either empty if U is not contained in V and will be reduced to just the inclusion map of U into V if U is contained in V. So this definition of it and the composition of arrows is, you have no choice because there's at most one arrow from one object to another. So this construction of a category in terms of an ordered set makes sense for any ordered set whatever. So the category which we have has as objects images of O and as arrows the graph of the order relation. A set of arrows, the graph of the order relation of O. Now let's first define pre-sheaves. A pre-sheave on X say F is by definition a functor which goes from the category O to the category of all sets. When I say a pre-sheaf, I mean a pre-sheaf of sets. Later we will introduce other types of pre-sheaves. But it should be a contravariant functor. So it's a functor which goes from the opposite category to O, and we know where O upper naught, to the category of sets. So let's recall what this means, that we have a functor. First of all, it means for every object of the category, that means for every open set U of X, we associate an object FU of the category of sets.
Ce qui est très important, c'est qu'il parle de faisceaux d'ensemble. Et le Ray parlait de faisceaux de groupe abélien.
Arrow of the category, that means for every inclusion map U goes into V of open sets, we associate a map from FV into FU in the opposite direction. This map will be called the restriction map, corresponding to the pre-sheaf. And the axioms are the evident axioms of transitivity. Namely, if we have V is contained in another open set W, then we have the restriction map from FV to FU, but also from FW to FV. And we want that the restriction map from FW to FU should be the composite term here. And moreover, we want that in the case when we take the identity arrow, the identity inclusion from U into U, we want that the corresponding map FU goes to FU should be the identity. So these are the axioms of functors. So a pre-sheaf on X is just a contravariant functor from the category O to, from the category O to sets, that is a functor from O naught to sets. And the category of pre-sheaf on X, how will we call it? Pre-sheaf on X is defined as being the category of all functors from O naught to sets. So the pre-sheaves can be viewed as being objects of a category, the category of all pre-sheaves, which is a category of functors. So what is a homomorphism of a pre-sheaf F into another G? My definition of homomorphism of functors. Let's say F be such a homomorphism by definition. F consists in a collection of maps from FU into GU. Call this map F of U for every U object of the category, that is for every open subset of X. And these maps of sets should be compatible with restriction maps. That means that whenever U is contained in an open set V, then we have also FV goes into GV by F of V. And we have the restriction maps here from FV into FU and from GV into GU. And these squares here should commute. So that's a homomorphism of pre-sheaf and homomorphisms. That's just homomorphism of functors, and they compose in an evident way by composing it argument-wise. You have FGH here, and here a homomorphism from the pre-sheaf G to the pre-sheaf H. That means for every U, a map from GU into HU, GU. The compositum of F, G and F is defined as associating to every U the compositum homomorphism here. All right, so that's just little nonsense on functors, on categories. Now, so far we have not used the fact that O was the category of open subsets of X. We have just used the fact that it's an ordered set. But we will use it now in order to define particular pre-sheaves on X, which we call sheaves on X. So we have